Hey guys, welcome to another video. This one's going to be about COVID breakthrough cases. So COVID cases, hospitalizations, and deaths, they're on the rise again. Right now, there are 162 million Americans who are fully vaccinated. Now, according to the CDC, less than 2% of people hospitalized with COVID are vaccinated. And get this, 99.5% of people who die of COVID did not get the vaccine. A COVID breakthrough infection is defined as someone who tests positive for COVID with a PCR test at least 14 days after being fully vaccinated. So there have been a number of reports of breakthrough infections. This includes at the White House, in Congress, at the Olympics, in Major League Baseball, especially with the New York Yankees, and more. Now, I've seen people with breakthrough infections in the ICU, but not nearly as much as COVID patients in the ICU who did not get the vaccine. Stanford is among nearly 600 universities and colleges nationwide that have required students and faculty to be vaccinated against COVID before coming back to campus in the fall. Now, Stanford had 7 fully vaccinated students who ended up getting symptomatic COVID in a week span. Now, even before the Delta variant showed up, we knew that the vaccines weren't 100% effective. Based on the original studies, we knew that the mRNA vaccines with Pfizer and Moderna were about 95% effective at preventing severe COVID illness, which means that the percentage is even smaller when you're talking about preventing mild or asymptomatic infections. But the important thing you want to know is, how effective is the vaccine at preventing severe COVID illness? That's what matters most. But that 95% effectiveness was based on the original strain of COVID. Now, the scarier and more contagious Delta variant makes just about all COVID cases in the United States. It's greater than 80%. Now, according to the recent study, when people are infected with the Delta variant, they have about 1,000 times more virus compared with the previous versions of the virus. So all that viral load has the potential to overwhelm the immune system, even in vaccinated people. Another study that was just published in the New England Journal of Medicine also showed that the Delta variant is slightly more likely to cause breakthrough infections. Researchers in that study found that after 2 doses of the Pfizer vaccine, it gave 88% protection against symptomatic disease caused by the Delta variant, and that's compared to 93% against the Alpha variant that was first discovered in the UK. For both doses of the AstraZeneca vaccine, it offered 67% protection against symptomatic disease. So we're still waiting on published numbers for the Moderna vaccine, but according to the company, its vaccine remained effective against the different variants. For the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, it might be less effective against the Delta and Lambda variants, but that study is yet to be published. It might be that for those who receive the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, they may need to get the Pfizer or the Moderna vaccine to protect against these new variants. So stay tuned on that. We know that for those who have been vaccinated, if they do become infected, they're going to have milder COVID illness compared to those who are unvaccinated. Now, this is based on another study that was also published in the New England Journal of Medicine, where they looked at more than 3,900 essential workers. It showed that fully vaccinated people are more than 90% protected against infection. Even partially vaccinated people, meaning they had 1 dose of the vaccine, are 81% less likely to become infected compared to those who haven't been inoculated. Vaccinated people appear to be less likely to spread the virus to others. Those who got breakthrough infections after either 1 or 2 doses of the vaccine had 40% less virus in their bodies, and they were 58% less likely to have fever. Also, they spent 2 fewer days in bed compared to unvaccinated COVID patients. Then there's the question, if you're asymptomatic and you've been vaccinated, can you still spread the virus to others? We know the vaccine reduces the likelihood of carrying the virus. And if you are carrying the virus, we know that it would otherwise be a reduced viral load. So overall, it's less likely that you're transmitting the virus if you're asymptomatic and you've been vaccinated. This is why the CDC says that fully vaccinated people can still be tested if they have symptoms and shouldn't be out in public for at least 10 days after a positive test. This is actually being studied right now in 12,000 college students who received the Moderna vaccine. And what about those of you who are vaccinated and you're concerned about getting a breakthrough infection? If you were to get COVID, it's way more likely to be a milder course of disease. One thing you can do if you're exposed to a lot of people, especially if they're not vaccinated, is to wear a mask. Now, the kind of mask to wear is a whole nother topic, but even a regular face covering would still be better at decreasing transmission compared to no mask at all. So that's going to be all for this video. Thanks for watching. If you haven't done so already, make sure you hit that subscribe button and bell notification. That way you don't miss out on my next one.